Hey guys, how's it going? Today we're talking about how to start your own online blog, how to get it set up, how to monetize it, and what you can do when you're creating your own brand and building your own blog. Let's check it out. Hey guys, I'm Andrew Wise with Life Tailored, and here we talk about style, travel, and everything else that makes your life amazing. Make sure to subscribe down below and like if you enjoy this video, and also follow me on Instagram at Life Tailored. So when you're building a blog, it's like building a business. It's something that's going to be permanent that hopefully one day in the future you can either live off of or sell. And the way you can do that is if you have something that's permanent. I have a ton of social media accounts on Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, Facebook, etc. But with all these accounts, I'm beholden to Facebook. I'm beholden to Instagram. If they make a change in their algorithm, I'm stuck with that change. There's nothing I can do about it. But when I own my own blog, I own my own business. So as these social media accounts go up, like Instagram's really big right now, or go down like MySpace did back in the day, my blog exists over that entire timeline and allows me, or it's going to allow you, to build your brand consistently as new social media platforms pop up and as just others disappear. Because when you have your own blog, it allows you to build your own mailing list. And that mailing list allows you to get direct access to your fans. So you don't have to wait for Facebook to change their algorithm or Instagram to change their algorithm to get to your fans. You have direct access to them. You also control everything that goes on your website. You know, Instagram and Facebook have really strict terms of service where you can't put out certain content. With your own website, you can put out whatever content you want. You can be as edgy as you want, or you can be as, you know, constrained as you want. The point being, you don't have to rely on them and their arbitrary sort of changes in practice. You control everything. So owning your own website and building your own blog is like creating your own business or starting your own brand. And what really is great about that is it allows you to sell your business. So over the past 8 years, I've sold a handful of different businesses, all because I owned the domain name and I built up a blog and a brand around that. Right now I run Life Tailored. I also run freesamples.us. These are two completely different brands and different blogs, but they're both, at the end of the day, WordPress blogs. So they're telling a story, creating value for advertisers, for publishers, for followers. So for me, the reason I started my blog is because it allowed me to build a brand that I could sell later on. So that kind of leads us into the second area. If you're starting your own blog, there might be two reasons you're starting it. One, you may have a passion where you just love doing what you do and you want to show your skills to the world. The one, it may be that you have a passion. You just want to tell the world about what you care about. Maybe it's fashion, it's pets, it's travel, whatever it is. The second reason might be because you want to make money. You want to one day earn a living doing what you love, or at least doing something that nobody else tells you what to do. The reason I started my own blog is because I didn't want to be dictated by a boss telling me what to do. I felt like I could do the research, I could figure things out myself, and I could build my own business. And that's what I did 8 years ago when I started my own first blog. It takes time, it takes dedication, but if you want to build your own business, starting with a blog is the best place to start. So now that we talked about like why you'd want to start a blog, let's talk about how you can actually make money and monetize the blog to kind of pay off your initial investment. So if you're starting a travel blog, a lot of PR companies are looking for online web coverage. Despite the fact that Instagram, Facebook, etc. are huge, they still want to see traditional articles on a website. So if you want to talk about travel, having your own travel blog and being able to put a write-up on there is really important for getting you somewhere in the travel industry. What we've found from our initial experience doing a travel blog is when you reach out to a PR company or a hotel and say, hey, I have this website that gets, you know, 50,000 unique views a month, they love that, and they've given us a ton of either free rooms or room upgrades or F&B, which is food and beverage credits, and this is a way to kind of monetize or at least get some value back from your travel blog. So if you want to start a travel destination or a travel brand, you need more than just Instagram. You want to start that blog so you can get those free rooms, the upgrades, and kind of add a lot of value to your packages. And the same thing goes for fashion bloggers. A lot of traditional PR fashion agencies still want to see those press clippings, and that press clipping takes place on your website. They're going to have a ton of PR releases. They want somebody to host. I get emails every day from PR companies saying, hey, we just released this new shoe. We published these 5 photos. Can you put it up on your blog? And I say, sure. It takes me maybe 5 minutes to publish it, and it gives the PR company something to show to their clients. I can't publish 5 random photos on my Instagram, but I can publish these 5 photos on the blog, no problem. So aside from kind of monetizing travel blogs and fashion blogs, or at least getting value out of having your own travel and fashion blog, one of the other ways to monetize your blog is affiliate marketing. Affiliate marketing is essentially performance-based advertising. The way it works is you might see a link down below where I say, if you want to start your own blog, you want to sign up with HostGator, or you want to sign up with Bluehost. Then if you go ahead and click on that link and sign up for a blogging account, I'm going to get paid a commission. Now, if you click on that link and don't do anything, I don't get paid. If you just look at that link, I don't get paid. So affiliate marketing only pays you, or it pays me, if you're driving an actual tangible result. That result could be getting someone to sign up for an email list. It could be getting someone to buy a product. It could be getting someone to submit a lead. So say I want to get Dish Network TV, and I go online and fill out a lead for somebody to call me. That's affiliate marketing. That's CPL. That's CPA. So there's affiliate marketing where you get paid to drive a specific result. Another way to monetize your blog is sponsored posts. So I get inquiries all the time from PR companies or influencer agencies saying, hey, we have this new release, it's Old Spice, it's a new deodorant, will you do a blog post about this? And this is pretty similar to the PR fashion releases they want me to do, except this time there's a budget, and I'm getting paid $500 or $1,000 or $2,000 just to write a blog post. These are kind of tough to come by in the beginning. This is something that takes time, so once you have a bigger audience, you're gonna get these sponsored posts. But that's yet another way to monetize your blog. Now, the easiest way to me to monetize a blog is doing something called AdSense. So AdSense is Google's built-in ad product. And basically all it is you take their code, you put it on your website, and then ads show up. You don't need any relationships with advertisers or any sort of traffic. All you really need is to put their code on your website. And as long as you have people going there, you get paid based on views as well as clicks. So you've seen these AdSense ads all over the web. They could be text ads, they could be graphic ads. And the way it works is you get paid every time somebody clicks on your ad. Pretty simple, really straightforward. Almost all blogs have AdSense ads on them. It was the first ads that I put on my site. And what's nice about this is, unlike sponsored posts where you need to actually communicate with someone or prove you have a lot of value, AdSense, it doesn't matter. As long as you have traffic and people are clicking on your ads, you can make money. It's a great way to build passive income for your blog, so you can get paid while you're sleeping or while you're traveling or while you're doing anything like that. So just to recap, there are three main ways to monetize your blog. There's one, affiliate marketing, there's sponsored posts, and then finally there's AdSense display ads. So I want to help you guys monetize your blog and kind of grow with you. So based on those ways of monetizing your blog, what are you thinking about doing for your blog? Write in the comments below. Are you going to start a travel blog and get some free hotel rooms? Are you going to become a fashion blogger? Are you going to monetize with affiliate marketing, sponsored posts, AdSense, or a combination of all of them? Let me know in the comments down below. I'll reply and help you out if you have any specific questions. Okay, so now that we know why to start a blog, how to get started making money with their blog, let's talk about your passion or what you want to blog about. You need to have a specific focus for your blog. For Life Tailored, my focus is style and travel. I write about menswear, men's accessories, lifestyle, and then what to wear when you travel. You gotta wear the suit, the shirt, all that sort of stuff. So that's my focus. Your focus could be anything. It could be pets, it could be camera equipment, it could be food snacks, it doesn't matter. What you wanna do is just figure out one specific topic and just write about it. Again, this is the same sort of thing down below. Add a comment for what your topic is. I'd love to hear, I'd love to give you some feedback as far as what might be a good topic, what's an untapped niche, all that sort of stuff. Now that we know what our topics are, how we're gonna make money, why we're starting this blog, let's walk you through how easy it is to start a blog. I would say it takes maybe 5 minutes to set up your blog. It's super simple. There are some questions you're gonna wanna answer that I go over in this quick little tutorial, but let's get started. So where do you want to start our blog? To me, the easiest and the fastest way to start a blog is to use a service like Bluehost or HostGator. I'm going to show you a walkthrough here for Bluehost. Bluehost is just like all these other low-cost web providers where it's, you know, maybe $5, $10 max per month. You may get the first month for free or discounted, but essentially it's going to be shared web hosting, which means your blog is going to exist amongst other blogs, which allows you to have share. These are the services I used for 5 years. Honestly, right now, I use a shared service with WP Engine for Life Tailored. So Bluehost, HostGator, they're not the fastest, but for $10 a month, this is probably the best service you can get, and it's gonna get you off the ground really quickly. If you do have any reservations about signing up for a cheap one right now, because you have plans, you know, you guys are gonna be huge, Don't worry, you can always transfer your blog, all your hosting information to another larger web provider at any time in the future. It's super easy to do that switch. But to get started, let's just talk about Bluehost. So I'm looking at Bluehost here, and right now they have an introductory offer for $3.95 a month. So to set it up, you go to Get Started Now, select your plan. I'm going to do the basic plan. It's got one website, 50 gigabytes of domain space. We're going to put in our domain name. Now, before we do this domain name, we have to do a little bit of research. So how do you choose your domain name? So in the past, I mentioned that you want to make sure you figure out that one vertical you're talking about. Is it style, travel, pets, etc.? So based on that vertical, you want to create a domain name. Your domain name is going to be your brand. You know, on Instagram, I'm at LifeTailored. Luckily, I'm LifeTailored.com. If you were LifeSnailered, you know, you're blogging about snails, the life of snails, you would want to see if you can get LifeSnailered.com. And then you'd also want to get the Instagram for LifeSnailered. The thing is, with LifeSnailered, it's a little tough. It might be a play on words and difficult to spell. So that might not be the best example. But say you're going for it. You love snails, you love LifeTailored, and you want to make this sort of riff account. So what you want to do is you want to get the .com domain extension if you can. If not, I think the .co is perfectly fine. I would not do a .net, I would not do a .org, not a .biz, not any of these other random LifeSnailer, .travel, or .website, or anything like that. Go for just the .com or the .co. So pick your brand name and see if the domain exists. If you go to Bluehost, you can type it in. I'm typing in LifeSnailer.com. Let's see if it exists here. I click next, and what do you know? LifeSnailered is available. So if you guys go ahead and register it after, let me know in the comments. I'd love to see. So once you figure out your domain name, go ahead and enter in all of your account information. Pick the basic plan. You could switch from 36 month to a 12 month plan, and it's only going to be $6 a month. Whatever you're comfortable with, I would do the 12 month plan at $6 a month. It's a $72 investment, which over a 12 month period, it easily pays for itself. You don't need to do any of the domain privacy or site lock or any of these sort of code guard basic things. Just do the basic thing, put in your credit card, hit submit. So once you've completed your account, you now want to install WordPress. WordPress is the free blogging engine that everyone uses. I think like 50% or more of the web uses WordPress. It's a blog that allows you to make any website you want. LifeTailored is built on WordPress, freesamples.us is built on WordPress. A ton of websites can be built on WordPress. Even if you're not building a blog, WordPress can be your framework. It can do a ton of things. It's free, it's got tons of support. All the design, all the plugins, they're all free, or for the most part, you can get great options for free. So we're gonna install WordPress, don't worry about it. Just go ahead and complete the Bluehost install, install WordPress, and then get everything set up. So now that we've got the WordPress all set up, we've got our login information, what we want to do now is start designing our blog. So with WordPress, there are things called themes, and this is basically the design of your site. There are thousands, if not millions, of free themes available. The easiest way to find a theme for your website is to type in WordPress themes, fashion, free. And it's going to give you a list of 25 best free fashion templates for WordPress, 30 best free, etc. Whatever your vertical is, there's going to be a free template that matches up for it, or a free theme. So go ahead and follow the instructions, install that theme, get it on your site, and basically you've got your website set up. So setting up your blog, here are the steps. Go to Bluehost, type in your domain name, install WordPress, add your theme. Now you're set up. You completed as quickly as 5 minutes, if not faster. Now that you've gotten your blog all set up, I'm going to focus on how to market your blog, how to monetize your blog, and how to grow it. So those are going to be videos I'm going to focus on for part two. But let me know, once you've got your blog set up, put it down in the comments, put your domain name, or message me, or something like that. Just add in the comments, what is your domain name? What do you think? I can help you out with anything you need as far as the plugins, the themes, any issues you run into with Bluehost, etc. Just drop a comment down below, ready to help. So guys, thank you so much for watching this How to Start a Blog. Hopefully by now you've set up your own blog. If you have any questions, let me know. But if you like this content, make sure to like and subscribe down below. And be on the lookout for part two, where I talk about how to monetize, market, and grow your blog. All right, guys, see you soon.